Hello, baseball fans, and welcome. We've got baseball on the show. It's the Los Angeles Angels taking on the Houston Astros. First pitch coming at you right after the break. Just about set to go now. And on the hill, the lefty, Framber Valdez. What do you have on him, Siggy?
Well, he comes at hitters with a five-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working, but if he can control four or even five of those offerings, look out, hitters. It's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep those guys off balance.
Okay, all set to go. So in now for the Angels, Taylor Ward. And the pitch. That misses, and we're off and rolling here in Houston.
First pitch, 7 o'clock.
Next offering is in for a strike.
1-1.
Pitch. Fouls it off, still 1-2. The wind to kick the pitch. Hacks and misses, it's a strikeout.
Good pitch right there. I mean, he's attacking a location that this guy at the plate tends to have trouble with. And there's just so much information in this day and age, sometimes too much information. But the guys that can take that information, process it, and then go out there, Boog, and execute the pitch, go right after that hitter and get the result that they were anticipating, that's really good pitching right there. And it's a good job of the pitcher and the catcher working together.
On the ground, and foul ball.
Mike Trout, just a special player, a special human, does everything well on the baseball field and seems to do it as well off the field.
On a line, base hit. Now he'll turn for second. Not stopping, he's going for three. The relay to third, and he's out.
Well, the defense definitely on the clock with that one. Everything had to be perfect to get the runner at third. When you talk about a throw on the money, the relay to third, just a good job all the way around.
Two outs, bases empty. Here's Shohei Ohtani. That misses off the outside edge. I think with Mike Trout, when you consider all the awards, the wins above replacement, he's on a trajectory, if he stays healthy, that he'll end up as one of the greatest position players of all time. And the 1-0. And a foul ball.
One of the unfortunate things is that in this guy's career, particularly early, we just didn't get to see him in the postseason very much. You want to see the best players playing in October.
The wind, the kick, and the 1-2. In the air, left side. This looks like extra bases. Safely into second. He's got a double.
Couple of hits in a row for him here. I don't know how he's able to shoot that pitch the other way and still put something on it. That pitch was inside and he let it get really deep, so pretty incredible hands to fight it off and still get good wood on it.
Now it's Hunter Renfroe. In there and it's 0-1. And takes low for ball one.
The strategy of winning a ball game, when you can make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job of extending this inning, getting a knock with two outs to bring the number four hole hitter up.
And that one hammered. This one's got a chance. That'll touch down off the base of the fence. In comes the first run of the game as the Angels take the lead. Pulls into second. That's an RBI double. Digging in, Jared Walsh. Fouled off. He was late. Framber Valdez had a great 2022. An all-star and, of course, as well, his Astros won the World Series. You won.
Yeah, Boog, and an ERA of under 3. Pitched over 200 innings and looked like they were easy innings for him. And finished 5th in the American League Cy Young Award voting.
In the air to left center. That one hops against the fence. The run comes in from second. It's 2-0. And that's a two-out double.
4 hits in a row, and they're really swinging it here.
Put a really nice balanced swing on it. And when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box. And he'll feel real good about that one.
Gio Urshela to the plate. Ball one there. Man on second, 2 down. And a count 1-2. The pitch. And that misses off the outside edge.
They've got him working a little harder in this first frame than he anticipated.
Next offering is down low. Matt Theis on deck for the Angels. First inning and already up to 23 pitches. To the right side, Altuve tosses to first, and that'll do it. But 2 runs for him, and they jump ahead. On to the bottom of the first. Angels 2, the Astros coming to bat. Back here in Houston, and towing the slab in this one, Reed Detmers.
Power pitcher. He's going to speed you up with the fastball velocity, and out of his hand will explode the breaking ball. Very difficult for hitters to keep that front side closed and hit the ball the other way, because they know if they're not ready to pull the trigger, the fastball will beat them.
Bottom of the first. Standing in is the power hitting second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Altuve.
The wind of the pitch. And that one clips the corner. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And that's downstairs and outside. Out to short. Sends it to Walsh. One up, one down. Now we check out the Astros lineup. Chris, this is a lineup offensively that could be really good for years to come.
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team. And I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
Alex Bregman, the next to hit, takes ball one. To the right side, Drury gathers and throws to first. Here tonight, an efficient start to the home first, two away.
The left fielder, Yordan.
Now it's Yordan Alvarez. Singing, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He is the ultimate professional, and it doesn't just start at game time. It starts in the afternoon, the way he prepares and gets ready for the ball game. I tell you what, his teammates feed off of the leadership that he shows on and off the field.
And there's the strike. Alvarez, who's from Cuba, he grew up idolizing a future teammate, Yuli Gurriel, who is 13 years his senior. 1-1 now. They say it went.
One ball, two strikes.
Here we go, Astros. And a 1-2. Got him swinging. Astros are down quietly. They trail it here 2-0. Back here at Minute Maid Park, all set for the start of the inning. Here's the Angels catcher, Matt Theis. Valdez back to work. Theis tries to check his swing. Now a look to third. And he won around. Ruled a swing. And now it's even up. Singy wasn't very sharp in the first, got hit around a little bit, just wasn't able to locate particularly well. A lot of stuff for the fat part of the plate.
Yeah, Boog, he wasn't fooling anyone. It's a tough place to be because it's not always obvious what adjustments need to be made. Sometimes it's location, sometimes it's being too predictable. Sometimes you're tipping your pitches. He's going to need to figure it out quickly, though.
The next pitch misses, 3-1 now.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with the 3-1 count.
Next offering finds the zone of the count is full.
Oh, you can throw that big curve on the inside part of the plate. Very difficult pitch for the hitter to get on plane with. You can have a lot of success if you can pitch in that location.
Bregman is under it, and there's one down.
Batting it. The second baseman,
Brandon Drury, to the plate. And that's outside, and it's 1-0. In the air, right field. Tucker should have it. Hauls it in for the out.
Batting up. The shortstop. Zach.
Two outs, base is empty. Number 9, the next to hit for the Angels. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Two down, nobody on.
Two balls, one strike.
Up the middle. On the run, sends it over to first. Angels retired, 1-2-3. And the Angels are gone in order. They're up 2-0. Bottom half of inning number 2. And here now is the Astros cleanup hitter, Jose Abreu.
Abreu.
Abreu, a really hard worker, a guy who takes his craft seriously in the batting cages and on the field during batting practice. He's always trying to stay in the big part of the field, not trying to have a home run derby during BP, but understands that those are typically mistakes when you're trying to hit line drives.
The 1-0. Now 1-1.
I got a ball, one strike.
And a pitch. Misses off the plate. 2-1. The pitch. And down on strikes. One away. Here's Kyle Tucker.
Kind of a throwback. No batting gloves.
That one's in there, 0-1. And a foul ball. Hot shot to third. Tosses across to first, and Tucker is retired.
Batting fifth. Not shortstop. Jeremy
Pena will hit next.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Clips the corner, strike one. Just missed. And a 1-1. And a swing and a miss.
Two strikes.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
I think the key is arm action on the changeup. When you can sell it like a fastball, you drop the velocity, you get the swing and miss, and you walk off the field.
On to the third inning. Leading now it's the Angels leadoff man, Taylor Ward.
Taylor Ward
getting the start in left, hitting leadoff in today's game. A former first-round pick back in 2015. The wind and the pitch. Two balls, no strikes to count. Misses with the 2-0, and he's fired three straight outside the strike zone. And a four-pitch walk.
Four pitches. That's an easy walk, man. He could have walked me right there, Boo. Last one wasn't even close.
And now batting, Mike Trout. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football. You feel like he could thrive in one of those sports, too. In there for strike one. Well, Singy, Mike Trout, the resume speaks for itself. A guy that's won multiple MVPs, multiple All-Star Game MVPs, a Rookie of the Year. I mean, he's going to go down as one of the best position players ever. Here's the 0-2. Got him swinging. One down.
Tell you what, those are the types of guys pitchers really like to punch out when they're on the mound, because if they get on, just the distraction that they create with all that speed over on the base pass, it could take away your focus from the next hitter, and that's the last thing you want to do is serve up a pitch that a guy hits over the fence, and it's a multi-run home run.
Snap throw to first, he's back in safely.
Yeah, Mike Trout, since the day he got to the big leagues, a superstar. And it's been amazing to watch, because earlier in his career, you figured he would taper off some. He wouldn't be a top three finisher in the MVP. Remember, several years he was finishing behind Miguel Cabrera, and then just emerged as the guy. And incredible to see what he's done over all these years.
Here comes the 0-1. Swings through that one for strike two. The 0-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Ward, the base runner at first with one out. Now snap throw to first. Ward back in standing. The pitch. Not even close there. It's a ball and two strikes. In the dirt, but kept close. No advance. Good job behind the dish. And the 2-2. Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Bogey just ran out of patience there. He took a couple of pitches to even that count up at 2 balls and 2 strikes, but that time chased outside the zone.
Right side, Altuve throws to first, and that will end the inning. Angels strand one, but they're on top 2-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And stepping in for the Astros, Chaz McCormick. The wind of the pitch. And he takes a strike. And here it comes. On the ground, out to short. Slings it across. And a quick out, number one.
Batting it. The designated hitter, Corey.
So, Singy, a close play at first, worthy of another look with StatCast.
That was an absolute heater, and you just don't see that type of velocity coming across the diamond every day. Only the best infield arms in baseball reach 90 miles per hour, and he needed all of it to get that out. Bang, bang play.
And next to hit for Houston, Corey Jolks. And that's in there for strike one. Jolks goes 6'1", 185 pounds. He's usually a third baseman, but today he's the designated hitter. One down, base is empty. That one fouled off.
A little bit of a day off for him. Instead of being at the hot corner, he can just kind of put the batting gloves on, hold the bat as he sits on the bench waiting for his time to hit.
Here comes a pitch. And ball one.
Two strikes.
Next pitch is popped up. Drury on the run, throw to first. And a couple of quick outs.
Batting done. The catcher, Martin Maldonado.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the catcher, Martin Maldonado. In there, and it's 0-1.
Not what he's looking for there in the 0-0 count. Looks like he wants the ball down in the zone.
Oh, one down. Foul ball there. And now the lefty going to count one and two.
Two strikes.
And now two and two.
Two balls, two strikes.
Kicks and fires. And there's a ball. Jose Altuve waiting to hit for Houston. Three and two now. And he walked him.
No, that's a ball. Take the base.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch. And I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Jose Altuve up to hit here.
Altuve.
Altuve, a member of the 1,000 hit club, can't forget to mention he's a former MVP. That one finds the corner. 1-1. Swings through that.
He finds himself in a tough situation early. Just got to try to simplify it. Take a knock the other way if you can.
Gets a piece and stays alive. Deal two. This one kicks away a little as he can't squeeze it. Well done behind the dish.
Let's get the win, Astros.
One and two now. Altuve waits. Here's a high fly ball out to center. And that is the inning. So the Astros leave one, and they're down 2-0. Back here at the ballpark as we go to the top of the fourth. And now the first baseman, Jared Walsh. And a pitch. And that's in the dirt.
You know, these Angels doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way. And I'm seeing very patient at bats out of them. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well.
There's a strike.
Still relatively early, but with the pair of runs already on the board, the ripple effect of that high pitch count might set them up to do more damage later in this game.
Left-hand batter waits.
That's a ball.
Kicks and deals. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Here's Gio Urshela. Grounded out his first time. In there for strike one.
And that's a great take right there. Even though it's a strike, with the situation runner on first base, you want to keep the ball off the ground. And you swing at that pitch, most likely you roll into a double play.
Next offering misses, and now it's even 1-1.
Runner
on the go. On the ground, right side. And that one finds its way through. And now runners at the corners, nobody out.
I really like the approach of that swing. That was a good changeup on the corner, but he recognized it early, did get jumpy, and just smacked it to the opposite field.
Theis comes up to hit here. 0-1 so far. Breaking ball inside. Ball one. At the belt and fires. And that one fouled off. Runners on the corners, no outs. Next pitch is outside, and that's ball two.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Here's a 2-1.
No, that's down.
Swing and a foul straight back. And they're all loaded up.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boog. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
And next for the Angels, Brandon Drury. 0-for-1 with a flyout. That one misses. 1-0.
Well, this is a tough situation with the bases loaded, but the healthiest mindset is just try to get outs one hitter at a time.
And now 2-0.
Pressure's on right here. 2-0 count, bases loaded. You don't want to fall to a 3-ball count and then walk in a run. He's got to challenge the hitter right here.
Next one off the plate inside. And now 3-0.
They need a strikeout, and you need a ball perhaps on the ground for a double play or get yourself a pop-up, something, but you've got to make some pitches. But if he can battle and get through this, he can earn some points.
Let's see if he gives them anything to hit here. That one down the line. That's a base hit. Run scores. Another scores. 2 runs in on the play, and it's 4-0.
Man, he just absolutely turned on that one. Ripped it down the line. Nice job of staying in his mechanics.
Number 9, the next to hit for the Angels. 0-for-1, he grounded out in his first at bat. That just misses, and that's ball one. And a pitch.
Ball two.
Activity in the bullpen. Parker Mashinsky getting ready to go. To Cal. Here it comes. Rolled to short. Possible 2-ball. There's one, and that's 2. And next for LA, Taylor Ward. Ball one, no strikes. The pitch.
Whoa, that's down.
Swing and a miss as he was late that time.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
The 2-1. Just missed. Mike Trout in the on-deck circle. Line drive. That's a base hit. Run scores.
Comes through with the RBI. Nice line drive to the pole side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still have to extend through the baseball in order to hit a line drive like that.
Now Trout gets a chance to hit.
3-pitch strikeout last time up. Got to put up more of a fight in this one.
Out there to center. McCormick has it sized up. Brings it in for the third out. Three runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left. We're midway in the fourth. Angels 5 and the Astros nothing. Back here in Houston, ready to go, bottom four. Here's Alex Bregman.
Third baseman, Alex Bregman.
Detmers back to work. And that's in for a strike.
Well, these Astros, as this game goes on, have to be more disciplined at the plate. They're chasing a lot of pitches outside the zone, and those chases are turning into a bunch of outs. Can they turn that around and stay within the zone? We'll see, but I think they have to.
They say it went.
No balls, two strikes.
Oh, and two now. Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. And the 0-2. And that's outside. And a 1-2. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Next one is off the plate, and the count's even at 2. And he deals. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
The left fielder, number
Here's Jordan Alvarez. He's a guy who does it all.
Alvarez.
With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on base and slugging too. Pitch misses inside, ball one.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power, but then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable. And because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
That one hammered left field. That's back. And that ball is gone. Yordan Alvarez circles the bases, and they've got their first run. It's 5-1.
That's the exact definition of hitting the ball where it's pitched, taking that outside fastball and driving it the opposite way out of the ballpark. You want to bottle that type of approach.
Jose Abreu up to hit. There's a swing and a drive. And it gets into the corner, but it's foul. Next pitch misses, 1-1. Jose Abreu, one of those guys with kind of a quirky number, number 79. It was a number his mother chose for him way back when. She said, pick a unique number and make it yours. High chopper to third, and he grabs it in foul ground. waves at the bender for the strikeout.
Not a great curveball there at all, but clearly he wasn't looking for it because it just dropped right into the happy zone, and it looked like, to me, the swing was a little bit late. Tells me he gave up on it early and then just tried to have that emergency hack at the last second to put it in play.
Tucker at the plate now. That's ball one. Next pitch is outside.
Back-to-back breaking pitches away, you get the feeling as a hitter that the pitcher's afraid of you, that he doesn't want to challenge you. So I think the confidence level is raised right here.
Next pitch misses inside, and it's 3-0.
After giving up that home run earlier, it just doesn't seem like he wants to challenge him.
And there's the automatic.
Thought the green light might be on right there, but maybe not. If you're looking to swing in that count, that's the pitch you want.
And that one hit to first. Walsh takes it to the bag, gets him easily, ends the inning. Astros get a run back here on the solo shot. It's now a 5-1 ball game. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Welcome back. Shohei Ohtani up to the dish. Pretty amazing athlete this guy is. Power and speed, quite a threat. I mean, you're talking about someone that could steal your bag and go deep. Bo Jackson, anyone?
Yeah, he's like Mike Trout. You figure whatever you put in his hand, whether it's a bat, whether it's a golf club, whether it's a basketball, he can do it and get it done. And a rare talent, so much fun to watch.
The lefty ready and a 1-1. Late swing, foul to the left. Pitch misses. Two balls, two strikes. The other way, and he beats the shift.
Just a simple ground ball the other way that had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
Manager out of the dugout now, and he'll make a move to dip into the Astros bullpen. Framber Valdez won't go any further. We'll be back in a minute with a new arm on the mound. Pitching change here, Parker Mashinsky. The offense will need to be ready for the breaking stuff. He's got a great curveball. Now it's Hunter Renfro. 1-for-2 with an RBI double back in the first. Now he can't squeeze it behind the plate. And no movement on the bases. It's ball one. Ohtani gets his lead at first with nobody out. Just off the inside edge.
You know, these Angels really impressing me with the quality of their bats in this one. It's been fun getting a chance to see them go to work. It looked to me like...
Over to Altuve. On to Jose Abreu. That's two.
Well, the reliever comes in, takes care of that inherited runner, gets that ground ball double play, and now he can work on one more guy to get back in the dugout.
So in now for the Angels, Jared Walsh. Slapped foul. Swing and a miss. No balls, two strikes.
Gonna really need to hang in there with that front side against this left-handed breaking ball.
One ball. Next offering is outside. The pitch. In the dirt. Throw to first. That completes the strikeout, and that'll do it. One hit in the inning, but nothing more than that. Home half of the fifth coming up. Angels 5 and the Astros 1. And welcome back. Bottom of the inning. And now the shortstop, Jeremy Pena. Pretty unique upbringing for Jeremy Pena, at least in terms of a kid who was born in the Dominican Republic, but then he moved to Rhode Island, not exactly a baseball hotbed, and he played his college ball at Maine. He was a University of Maine Black Bear and then went on to be a third-round pick of the Astros in 2018. Slice to right, and that's a fair ball. And that rolls into the corner. Now he turns and heads for second. And it's a leadoff double to start the bottom of the fifth.
Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy. Didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep. Took the barrel right to it. And then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit. Could be a chance here for them to start clawing back into this ballgame.
So a man aboard. And now Chaz McCormick. Grounded out to short in his first trip. There's a strike at the knees. It's 0-1. They've got a potent lineup. And when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. Runner at second, nobody out. There's a strike. Little trouble with this one behind the plate. Tag, safe! He's in the third of the wild pitch.
Well, that right there can be a tough read as a runner on second to see if the ball's gotten away enough to move to third. You have to be sure you can make it because you're already in scoring position. Well, he was sure there, and now he's only 90 feet away from scoring.
The 1-2. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout, and there's one away. Corey Jolks up next for the Astros. He's 0-1.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
That one's in there, 0-1.
Well, he's been incredibly efficient in this one. First pitch strike percentage over 70%. That's well above league average, and that's what's allowed him to pitch well up until this point.
And a foul ball. The pitch. That misses the zone. Now 1-2.
The idea was right. Looking to locate that fastball up and in. He just missed his spot a little bit.
Pitch misses there. Two balls, two strikes.
Let's find the hole.
Kicks and fires. Bounce to the right side. There for the out. Runner scores from third. Martin Maldonado up to hit.
The catcher, Martin Maldonado.
Check swing, went around, and it's 0-1. The wind of the pitch. Strike two. Swings and misses. Picks up strikeout number seven. But they push across one run, one hit, no errors, and no one left on. Five innings complete. Angels 5 and the Astros 2. Back here in Houston, start of the sixth, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton. And leading off, Gio Urshela. Mashinsky back to work. Not close with that one. And that's ball one. Activity in the Houston bullpen. Hector Neris getting loose out there. Maton getting loose as well. The pitch. And that one wrapped foul. Foul ball. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. The pitch. Ground ball left side. Fires across the diamond. Leadoff man retired in the sixth.
Now batting the catcher, Matt.
And now, Matt Theiss. Theiss, 27 years old, usually a first baseman, today starting behind the plate. That one missed.
Yeah, Boog, and I think that's a tougher transition to make going from first base to putting on the catcher's gear, being behind the dish. A lot of times you see guys go from playing catcher to being a DH or a first baseman.
Ball, no strike.
Two
ball, one strike.
Swing and a miss. It's 2-2. On the ground right side, Abreu steps on the bag. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
Up next to the Angels, the second baseman, Brandon.
Now it's the second baseman, Brandon Drury. Swing and a line drive curling foul down the right side. Next offering is in for a strike. Swings and misses, struck him out. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. Angels 5 and the Astros 2. Back here at the ballpark, here's the former MVP, Jose Altuve. One of the skill sets Altuve brings to the table, he is a notorious bad ball hitter. But whether it's in the zone or out of the zone, since he debuted in 2011, no player has more hits in the majors than Jose Altuve. Next one is off the plate. And now 2-0.
Yeah, Boog, and Altuve, a three-time AL batting champ and the first second baseman to win multiple batting titles since Hall of Fame second baseman Rod Carew won five batting titles between 1969 and 1975.
Here's a 3-0. Yeah, there's the strike.
Yeah.
on the ground, right side. The throw to first, one away, bottom of the sixth.
Third baseman number two, Alex Bregman.
Now it's Alex Bregman. That hits the dirt, and it's 1-0. That one drifts inside. There's a strike.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Two one now. Curveball over for a called strike.
That curveball's been a big pitch for him today. He's been able to get ahead in the count with it. He's also been able to use it to put guys away.
Laced to right center, base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Everything came together for him. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle, allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
Yordan Alvarez up next for the Astros. And that's in there for strike one.
Now, these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
Next offering is in for a strike.
0-2 count, both pitches on the inside part of the plate. Hitter is thinking, I don't want to get beat here. This is a good time for something off speed away.
Left-hand hitter waits. Swing and a miss. Slider got him for strike three.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Guys become defensive, and all of a sudden, for the hitter, that plate starts to get really wide. And what happens is, because of the pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout. Well, an at-bat can be a little bit of a dance, strike one here, but a few more pitches. We'll see how it turns out.
That one finds the corner, and it's nothing in two.
An at-bat like this is almost over as it begins. In this situation, you have no idea what the next pitch is going to be. You just got to hope that you can make contact.
Next one misses, and it's 1-2. Activity in the bullpen for the Angels. Chris Devensky, the veteran right-hander, appears to be loosening up. Moore, the lefty, warming up as well. The 1-2.
That's ball two.
Bregman off of first with two away. Inside 3-2 the count. Kyle Tucker hoping for a chance. He would represent the tying run.
Yeah, Boo, plenty of power in that bat. They'd love to give him a shot here.
And the pitch. Got him looking. That's a strikeout. One left for Houston, and the deficit remains 5-2. We go to the top of the seventh. So in now for the Angels, number nine.
Zach Neto.
And here it comes. Little chopper rolls foul. And the 0-1. late with the swing there.
Man, he was really tardy on that fastball. Great job of setting him up by throwing the curveball. Add some velocity to it on the next pitch. Can't catch up.
And down on strikes he goes. And the leadoff hitter set down to open the seventh.
Committed to that breaking ball just a little too much and couldn't pull the bat back in time. You know, once you get it going, it can be so tough to stop the momentum of that barrel. Good pitch, had him fooled.
Hit hard on the ground to short. Over to Abreu and two away to start the seventh.
The center field, number 27, Mike.
Here's Trout. Great speed and great power. A great athlete, quite simply.
When you have a real athletic player and who's able to do the baseball mechanical things really well, look out, because the sky's the limit on that potential.
That one misses. 1-0. So two balls and no strikes. Other thing in this park, I mean, he could sneeze one over the left field wall into those Crawford box seats. That one outside, and that's ball three. Shohei Ohtani up next for the Angels. Here comes a pitch, and it's ball four. He missed down low.
You know, I think he's okay with that outcome. It wasn't an intentional walk, but he wasn't exactly trying to attack the zone either.
So two down. Now it's the DH for the Angels, Shohei Ohtani. And that one cutting but missing down low. The 1-0.
I got one ball, one strike.
Let's get the win, Astro. And there's a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
The 1-2. Battling here as he fouls it away. And a pitch. Swung on, belted. Tucker going back, racing back some more. And that ball is out of here. Shohei Ohtani goes deep, and they add a couple more. It's 7-2. Zingy, he's been red hot.
Yeah, another big swing of the bat for him. Man, he is really seeing the ball well in this one. There was a cutter away. Kind of works like a slider. You got to stay on it, let it travel a little bit, and then get your arms extended. Really good piece of hitting right there.
To Renfro at the plate. That one's in there, and that is strike one. Two outs. Ground ball Abreu. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. It's now a 7-2 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh, Jaime Barilla.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
Number 51, Jaime Barilla.
Kyle Tucker getting ready to hit.
The right fielder, Kyle Tucker.
and a pitch. And fouled off. And the right-hander deals.
Hey!
That one off the mark, and that is ball one. Way inside, gets out of the way. Oh, that got away from him. And he's going to reach on a hit-by-pitch to lead off the inning.
Well, it definitely didn't come out of his hand the way that he was intending it to, and the release point is a little bit off as well. If you're going to get something going, this is the time to do it. You get the leadoff man on. Everybody's got to look over the shoulder and say, I'm just going to keep the line moving. Don't try to do too much.
To the right side, and it goes just foul. Tucker gets his lead at first. Nobody out. And the righty deals. Fouls it back with two strikes. Kicks and deals. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout. And, Chris, that's a way to neutralize his speed by keeping him off base.
And the defense breathes a sigh of relief because he puts pressure on everyone if he can put the ball in play. But that's how you do it. Keep him off balance, get him out of there, and deal with the next guy.
McCormick stands in here, leaves that one off the inside. Called strike right there.
Well, that's really the money spot. Down and away, if you can locate that consistently, it's going to be real tough for guys to square that up. That's what you love to see relievers do coming out of that bullpen.
Righty delivers. Pitch misses there. And a count 2-1. Back up the middle and a base hit. They fired in quickly. So it's first and second with only one away.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle.
Other than ripping one into the gap or blasting one over the wall, there aren't a whole lot of hits that are more satisfying than a nice line drive in the center field. So that definitely felt good.
Jolts in the box now. No balls and a strike.
Really good job in this spot to get ahead in the count. He's going to have to continue, finish off this hitter.
And that one is lifted in the air. And that will fall. Throw back in, holds the runner at third. Base is now loaded. Only one away. Base is loaded with one away. Martin Maldonado up next for the Astros. A strikeout and a walk.
All right, let's bring it in.
That's in there, and that's strike one.
Tough situation right here. So important as a pitcher to get ahead in the count as he did right there.
And a pitch. Next offering misses down and away. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. Slider got him for strike three.
Wow, just great bite to that slider. Broke hard out of the zone, and he just couldn't hold up the swing. You know, as a hitter, that pitch is really hard to take, and there's just not much you can do with it. You know that, but you don't want to get rung up by the umpire.
Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. Altuve started after it, tried to hold up. Now a look to first. Yes, he did. That's a swing. Right-handed reliever. Hard hit left side. Slings to first, and they get Altuve for the out. Play made. That ends the inning. Astros leave them loaded. They're down five. It's 7-2. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Phil Maton. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Jared Walsh digs in now.
The first baseman, Jared Walsh.
The pitch. That's in for a strike. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. Misses inside at a count 1-2. And another ball. The next offering misses, and it's 3-2. Right-hander kicks, deals. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Oh, you know this guy wants to swing it, but he's showing some good patience in this one. It's the second time he's taken ball four.
Man at first. Here's the third baseman, Gio Urshela. That one inside, and that's ball one. Activity in the bullpen for Houston. Hector Neris is loosening up. This would be his first appearance for the club. Walsh on at first, nobody out. Swing and a miss, and the count is 1-1.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
Grounder might be two. Altuve on to first. First out in the top of the eighth.
Now Matt
Theis, the next to hit for the Angels. First offering misses the mark. Runner at second here, one gone. Next offering is fouled back.
Have you ever caught a foul ball as a fan?
Only as a broadcaster, not as a fan. You?
I haven't been in many games as a fan.
Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike two. The 1-2. That's and that one upstairs.
Two balls, two strikes.
Bounce to the right. And he handles it himself for the out.
Now second baseman,
Brandon Drury, the next to hit for the Angels. Just missed. Two outs and one in scoring position. That one well upstairs. Now 2-0. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. The run scores from third, and it's now a 6-run lead.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Timing on the swing was good, able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off.
Number 9, the next to hit. And a good fastball to start him off at strike one. Swings through that one out in front that time.
Well, that's that slurve right there. He threw it extremely well. You talk about just a ton of breaks. So tough to get that barrel to.
And he deals. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Kicks and fires. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Snuck the fastball by him. A run, a hit, and a man left. Last half of the eighth coming up. It's the Angels 8 and the Astros 2. On to the bottom of the eighth, and stepping in for the Astros, Alex Bregman. The why to kick the pitch. And that one off the outside edge. Action in the Angels bullpen. Aaron Loop, the veteran southpaw, is getting ready to come on if needed. The pitch.
In this situation, you expect the batters to be a little more patient, possibly take until they get a strike. With that, you don't want to miss your opportunity to get ahead early in the count. He didn't right there.
Next pitch misses outside, and it's 2-1.
Pretty easy to give up on that pitch right there. Started on the edge of the plate with the spin. You know it's going to finish well off the plate.
That one clips the outside corner. That is strike two. The wind and the pitch.
Full count.
The only adjustment he needs to make is his target. If you aim at the outside corner, that slider's going to end up way off the plate. Perhaps look a little more down the middle, and you get it right where you want it.
Payoff pitch. Fights it off. You'll see another. We'll see another payoff pitch. And here it comes. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Chop to third. Urshela to first in time. And they get Bregman for the out.
The left fielder, number 44, Yordan Alvarez.
So next up for Houston, Yordan Alvarez. He's already homered here in this one. And first offering is fouled off. The wind of the pitch. That's inside. Inside. ground ball to the right side, and that's just foul. Another 1-2. Got it by him for the K.
Toughest pitch to hit. Fastball on the outer black. Man, sometimes you just got to tip your cap.
Jose Abreu up next for the Astros. Swing and a miss. 0-1.
He's had a tough day at the plate. 3 strikeouts already. It's hard not to think negative, but you got to find a way to somehow center up the baseball and put it in play.
Line drive, base hit.
Bolley's been having a hard time just putting the ball in play in this one, so that should help soften the blow. Great hands on that swing. Took the barrel right to the baseball, caught it out front, and ripped it into the gap. At that point, there's probably no question in his mind that he was going for 2. That's just a great feeling.
And the batter now, Kyle Tucker. That one called a strike. 1-1. That's a little bit low. Here's a 1-2. Hammer, base hit. So that's 2 straight, 2-out hits.
Right there, he does a great job of staying in the big part of the field. Man, there are a lot of hits there.
Jeremy Pena.
And the batter will be the shortstop, Jeremy Pena. There's a strike.
0-1's the count.
Righty to the plate, and that one fouled off. The pitch squirts away a little bit, sends it to Walsh. That's the 3rd out. Inning over. This one pretty well decided at this point. Through 8 full, it's the Angels 8 and the Astros 2. Back here in Houston, we go to the 9th. Now it's the Angels' leadoff man, Taylor Ward. And a pitch. And there's a strike. Good eye right there. Here comes a pitch. And that one a little bit high. On the ground to short. Rolls across the diamond. And they get the leadoff man in the 9th.
Now batting the center fielder, Mike.
Here's Mike Trout. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. In there, and it's 0-1. And strike 2.
No ball, 2 strikes.
And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Maldonado makes the catch. And there's two away.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Shohei.
And now the DH, Shohei Ohtani. This guy has turned into a beast. Swing and a grounder, foul, first base side. The pitch. Good eye right there. Good eye in that spot. Outside. The 3-1. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. At the belt and fires. That one is absolutely belted. Alvarez going back on this one. Pulls it in the warning track. Three up, three down for him there. Bottom part of the order. 7-8-9. Two up in inning number 9. It's the Angels 8 and the Astros 2. A new arm into the game. The righty, Jacob Webb.
And you know, bullpen guys can struggle sometimes when they're called upon with big leads because it just doesn't have the same intensity as a tight game. So we'll see how sharp he is. Your mental toughness matters in situations like this as well.
And a pitch. McCormick, the leadoff batter, as he looks at ball one. Next offering upstairs. And there's the strike.
One way to make a guy real uncomfortable at the plate is pound him inside with good velocity. They're doing that right here.
And a pitch. Looked like it was a little bit up. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Dice makes the play. And there's one away.
The designated hitter, number 9.
Corey Jolts up next for the Astros. Webb measures 6 feet 2 inches, 210 pounds. He joined the team as a free agent. In there for strike one. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Aaron Loop, the southpaw, is throwing and getting that sinker dialed in. Here's your one. Late swing, fouled off. Line drive, and it's caught for the out.
Now batting, the catcher, Martin Maldonado.
At the plate is the Astros catcher, Martin Maldonado. And strike one to the catcher. Pitch is in there. No balls, two strikes. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Good win by 6 runs. Always nice when you can win by a touchdown or a couple of field goals. You want to keep that momentum going, knowing the offense can score at will, bring it into the next one and get another W.
8-2 the final here for Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show. Thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Angels, 8 runs, 10 hits, no errors, they left 4 men on base.